In this session, I'm going to talk about filtering data within Business Central. So Business Central always gives you the data open-ended, right? It gives you all customers, all vendors, all details, and it's up to you to filter down that data based on what you're looking for. Now, whether that be in master records or in reporting or just analyzing data. So let's give you an example of how filtering can help you find what you're looking for. So, and when I go through this, it's going to be the same throughout the system. So even though I may be in a customer list, it works the same whether you're in a geo list, vendor list, item list. If I'm in the details, whether it's a subledger list or a financial data list, everything works the same. So, you know, what you're about to see, just think of it as no matter where you are in the system, it's going to work the same. So let's start simplistic and go into a customer list. Now, as I mentioned, customer list can give you all my customers. And you see, for an example here, balance, due, sales, and so forth. You got a lot of zeros, you got dollar amounts. So if I want to just filter down my list, I'm going to click on my funnel here. And this opens up my filter over here on the left-hand side. And I could actually click on filter, and it shows you all the fields that really exist within that record. So because I'm on the customer list, it's going to give me all the fields that pertain to the customers. So I could look through what I'm really looking for to filter down. Okay, so let's go for balance due. So I'm going to type in balance due. So now it's saying, okay, here's your filter. You want to filter in balance due. So what I want to do is I'm going to do a less than sign, greater than sign, which that really means not equal to, and I'm going to put in zero. So that's telling me, show me all my customers that are not equal to zero within my balance due. So if I click enter, lo and behold, it just filtered out all of my customers that don't have a balance. So now my list, I'm only showing my customers that have balance due. So that less than, greater than really means not equal to zero. Okay, and I could put any dollar amount here, obviously, positive or negative and so forth. I could also go maybe if I want to say what's less than zero, which that would show me anybody that has a credit balance. And if I hit less than zero, you'll see, oh, that means your answer is you don't have any, right? But what if I did something greater than 10,000? And now I got my answer is two customers that are greater than 10,000 balance due. And I could continually create more and more filters. So I could layer my filters one on top of each other if I chose to. Now, what if this is a common filter that I always want to go into? And instead of having to always reset it, because once you close the page, it typically erases itself, right? Unless you save that filter. And what I could do is if I like this, and let me go back to my not equal to zero filter. So that way, every time I go into my customer list, if they don't have a balance with me, then I don't care to see them every time I go into my customer list. So I want to save this, so I don't have to reset it every time. So up here, you'll see a save button. Save as, and I'm going to say balance due. Oops, if I can spell right, balance due. So now I have a filter that's called balance due. So if I was to get out of here, I'm going to refresh, go back into my customer list, and you'll see how my customer list is back to the same thing, but I have my filtered already saved, so I don't have to reset. I just click on balance due, and now it gives me exactly what I've always wanted to see. It's my balance due. So now I'm only, instead of resetting the filter, I save the filter, and it gives me, so now it's just easy to use one click. And again, I can have as many saved filters as I want to, and I can do layers upon layers of filters within one saved filter. Let's look at another example. So this was on a customer list. So if I drill down into my balance due, this gives me the actual details, right? So now that I have detail information, let's just say I want to remove this filter, because now what I did is I drilled down into the details for the customer, but maybe I want to see both open and yes means open, right? So then my open ones and closed ones. So if I close this out, now it's showing me all my open and closed entries. This is giving me everything. So it gives me something a little bit more. So now I see all the details for this customer, right? But maybe now that I'm in here, I want to see something. Maybe I'm looking for a specific invoice within a specific time. So now I want to say my posting invoice. I want to say I want to find everything. I knew it was sometime in February. So what I want to do is I'm going to go 020120, and I'm going to do period, period, dot, dot, period, period, right? 022820. So what that's showing is they show me all my transactions that were posted from 2-1 through that period, period, right? That dot, dot, period, period. That means through. It's saying from this criteria through this criteria. In this case, I'm looking for all my transactions from one date through another date. And now I'm looking at all my data that only transacted between the month of February. Okay. And now, again, another, so you see the layers of filters. I could continually add to it by adding filter. And maybe I want to have document type. So that way I could now see, well, I got a mixture of payments and invoices. Maybe I want to just look at payments. And now you see I have payments only. I'll take that back off, and maybe I want to see just invoices. Now I only see invoices. So again, you'll see layers. My first layer is customer number, due date through the 15th, transactions only through February that are invoices. Right. And again, I could actually save this filter if I choose to. So that way I don't have to enter it all over again. Okay, now again, this works the same, as I mentioned, whether I'm on a geo entry table, a customer subledger, vendor subledger, inventory subledger, customer list, vendor list, geo list, etc. It's really getting to know the filtering criterias that you want, that you're looking for. So I gave you an example of less than, greater than, less than, greater than, through, which is, again, as that's a period, period, right, and so forth. What a lot of people also look for is maybe something that is blank. So for an example, if I'm going to clear out all my filters. So if I'm just going to, by Xing these out, it clears out all my filters. And if I was to post something within my ledger, and I'm looking for something that doesn't have a criteria, for example, whether it's a posting group, external document number, what have you, you're looking for a blank code. Another example that I use commonly is external document number. If you do single quote means blank. Okay, so if I was to do that, in this case, that I'm going to see there's a filter, and what it's looking for is, like, you didn't notice anything, but you notice one thing you may notice is the filter turned on, saying you got a filter set. I could click on this, and you could say either clear this filter, open up the filter, and so forth. Now, this is blank. So what if I did not equal to single quote blank? And now you'll see, what did I find? It found a payment that had an external document number of B00, because my filter was not equal to blank. And that blank, single quote, really means blank to the system. So you get very familiar once you start working with the system. Certainly, there's a lot more filter formats that you could use, but I think the single quote is very common for blank. Period, period, dot, dot is for through. Less than, greater than is very useful. I'm going to show you one more that's a very popular, but yet at the same point in time, underused type of filter. So I'm going to get back out, and I'm going to stay on my customer list. And again, this works the same throughout. Doesn't matter where you are within the system. But there's also called a wildcard. Okay, so if I go into filter, and that's not the filter I want, let's go into this filter, and let's go by name. And I'm going to use name. It doesn't have to be name, it could be number, it could be name, it could be phone numbers, etc. And we're going to use a phone number for an example. What if I want to find all my customers that have an area code of 540? I'm going to type in 540, then star. So that's your wild card, right? So the star is your wild card. So what that's telling me, what you're telling the system, is to find everything that starts with 540 and then anything after that. And it didn't find anything. Oh, I was under name. I'm sorry. That was my fault. So what I want to do is I said phone number, right? I just chose the wrong one. My apologies. 540 star. And now you'll see the phone number, everything. Now I'm seeing all my customers that start with 540. Okay, and just like I said, if this is very common, I deal with all my customers that are in the 540 area, I could actually save that and I could do 540 customers. So now you'll see I have now two set filters. I could do balance two filters if I click on that, or I got my 540 filters, right? So I got many filters there. So this wildcard could be either set before, or maybe I want to see everything that is after. So if I did star 6, for an example, so that's everything up to find 6. And you'll see, phone number wise, this is 6, this is 6, this is, you see the last number is 6, because we told it find everything you find before, but the last number has to be 6, right? So it gives you examples of how you could quickly find data that you're analyzing by using the star, the through, the less than, the greater than, and so forth, right? And there's going to be one more I'm going to show you. Okay, I'm going to take this out. And because again, very popular filters, it's really up to you to learn these and use them accordingly. So there's one other filter I'll just use as a number. And what this is called a pipe sign. The pipe sign is used, means kind of like and or, if you will, without using the plus sign. So if I want to see only my customers that are, that has a number of 10,000, I'm going to do pipe sign 50,000. Now that gives me just those two customers. And I could keep on adding other pipe signs. So I could add another pipe sign and say, show me 30,000. And now I got the three customers. So this, what's called pipe sign, really means and or. So now it's telling, I'm telling the system, show me these three customers. That's all I really care to say. And again, if I wanted to, I could save it. So just a recap, you get the pipe sign, which means and or. Star is the wild card. Two periods together is through. You get the less than only, greater than only, or less than greater than, which equals not equal to. And then, of course, single quote really means blank. Hope this helps. Thanks for watching. If we could further assist you, please reach out to us here at epcgroup.net.